You want to make your bot writing experience much more enjoyable? You're not going to want to miss this episode of the AI Show, where Tony takes us through the new Bot Framework Emulator, new and improved, shiny, amazing. You're not going to want to miss it. Take a look. Hello and welcome to this episode of the AI Show, where we're going to talk about the new Bot Emulator. Did I get it right?
That is right.
How you doing, Tony?
I'm doing well. How are you doing?
Good. Tell us who you are and what you do.
So yeah, my name is Tony Anziano, and I am one of the developers on the Microsoft Bot Framework and Azure Bot Service team. And over the past few months, I've been working a lot on the new Bot Framework Emulator, and I'm pretty excited to show you guys some of the new features we have.
All right, let's take a look.
Okay, and for any of those who don't know the Bot Framework Emulator or the Microsoft Bot Framework, check us out on our website at dev.botframework.com. Also on Azure under products in AI and machine learning. And then we also have some getting started resources and docs on docs.microsoft.com.
Fantastic. So you got all the deets. Now let's take a look at all the bits.
Okay. So here's kind of this end-to-end development workflow we have that's around developing a bot from start to finish. And we've centered this around this new suite of tools we have called Bot Builder Tools.
Nice.
Appropriately dubbed.
Of course.
Okay, and so the emulator doesn't cover all these areas, but what it does cover is planning, testing, and refining your bots. And it excels at those pretty well. So
awesome. Yeah, because like once you start building bots, the first one you build, you're like, oh, now I get this. I have to actually plan this like I do all my software, which takes a bit of time.
Yeah.
And these tools are designed to help with that.
Correct.
All right, let's take a look.
Okay, so so we have this new transcript mode and or presentation mode and transcripts, which help you basically view mocked conversations as they would look in production without having to write a single line of code. So that's pretty cool.
Cool.
For testing, we have all the core functionalities of the old bot emulator, which basically allows you to set breakpoints in your code and have a full debugging experience. And refining your bot, we have this really cool piece of UI called the inspector panel, which allows you to look at all the underlying structure of your messages to and from your bot and your network traffic and all that stuff. So
you can actually get in there and debug.
Yeah, you can see what's going on behind the scenes, everything. Okay, so now that I've talked about all this, let me kind of dive in and show you what I'm talking about here.
Let's do it.
So here we are in the new emulator welcome page. You can see we've given it a pretty significant facelift for any of those who have used the old one. And so basically, what I'm going to do is show you transcripts and what those are, because they're a brand new concept.
Okay.
So let's go ahead and open this transcript in the left over here. And now what you'll see is it has populated this web chat window with basically every conversation or every message in this conversation's history, just like we had this conversation right here.
This is literally like wireframing your old apps that we used to have Windows with, right? This is like wireframing a chat.
Right, exactly. So what a transcript is, it's basically just a record of a conversation you had with a bot that the emulator can understand.
Is it, what kind of format are we talking about? Is it a complicated format?
No, it's basically just a JSON array of just a bunch of conversation activities.
So you can literally type one up in Notepad if you want.
So I'll get to that later. That will be with ChatDown, and that converts to a transcript. But transcripts are actually auto-generated by the emulator. So I'll show you how to do that.
Fantastic.
So basically, let's open up a live chat. So this means I'm talking with a remote bot right here. We can see it's talking to testbot.botframework.com. So testbot is just going to, echo back whatever I say. Hey, testbot, we'll say hey. I can give it a smiley face, echo, stuff like that. And basically, getting a transcript file from this is as easy as going up here, hitting save transcript as, and then you just say, just made this. And we can save it. We can see it populated in this file explorer window to the left. And we can click that and open it, and boom, there's the conversation we just had with TestBot.
That's cool.
So, and then one other way to do it is with our new tool called ChatDown. So real quick, I'll show you how easy it is to create a transcript from a chat file with ChatDown. So basically what we want to do is just say, okay, what is our user's name going to be? That's going to be me. We're going to say, what is our bot's name going to be? That's going to be DemoBot, I guess. And then basically, it's as easy as writing back and forth what you want each person to say to one another.
I see.
Yeah. So I'll say, hey, how's it going, DemoBot? Oh, just noticed a typo. Okay. And then DemoBot's going to respond with, hey, I'm doing really well. What can I?
Typing, man.
Typing is so
hard.
That's
why we have bots that speak.
Hey, I'm doing really well. What can I assist you with today? And you know, I'm just going to say, oh, I was just wondering what you think of the demo so far.
Well, you're a fast typer, though. I will give you that.
It helps, you know. And DemoBot is going to say, you know, well, to be honest, I think this is probably the best demo I've ever seen.
Nice.
You know, DemoBot's really nice.
Of course.
And so we're going to save this in our folder here called, we'll just call it demo.chat. So a chat file is what is consumed by our tool ChatDown.
Okay.
And ChatDown's not included in the emulator, but you can install it via npm and stuff like that. It's really easy. So we can go back to our folder here. We can see the demo chat is in there, and all we have to do is ChatDown, the name of the chat file we want to convert, pipe it into the name of the transcript file we want to generate.
Nice.
And then we just wait a little bit, and it's done. It's that fast. And then we go, and we can see that demo.transcript is in our little file explorer.
Mm-hmm.
We can click that. Boom, there's the conversation
we
just had.
Nice. So it was even smarter than my dumb text file idea.
Right. Yeah.
Nice. It's like you thought about this.
Yeah, we thought about it. You know, we have everything covered.
So a couple of questions about this when you're doing these is there a way to do like the cards in line as well?
Yeah, so just for the sake of time, I just did a purely text-based demo. But yeah, you can do you can send, you know, little typing notifications and delays and also, yeah, rich content cards like adaptive cards.
Awesome. So what other features are you going to show me?
We still have some of our core functionality. So I just want to show you that, you know, let's switch to another bot here, actually. Oh, well, actually, before I do that, let me show you presentation mode. So let's say, you know, you just mocked up a real quick conversation. You didn't have time to work on this concept you were thinking about, but you wanted to show your team what a new bot idea would look like.
Sure.
And so, you know, you don't want to show them this UI. You want to show them, boom, this, you know, presentation mode. You just hit presentation. It goes into this full screen kind of cinematic mode, and
nice.
It kind of just shows you just the focus of the chat window. So
I love it. So when you're wireframing and showing the stakeholders, they can be like, yeah, I totally love this conversation.
Right.
And then it'll just
You can see how fast I just whipped up that transcript. And you know, we went from a text file to this in like, I don't know, 2 minutes.
Love it.
So pretty fast. Okay, so let's go look at some of the other functionality we have. I'll open up this cafe bot. The cafe bot is running locally. So just to show you some of the core functionality we still have, I will show you that we can still put breakpoints in our code here. So here's just the source code, and I'll just break on when we get a response back from Lewis. And then I'll talk to the bot. Hey. And now we can see that we hit that breakpoint. We can step over, and we can see that, hey, we got this Lewis result here with, it's kind of small, but we got this Lewis result with all these entities and stuff like that.
Cool.
Okay, and then we'll just go through that, remove this breakpoint. Okay, and then some of the other functionality we have is we can open two simultaneous live chats at a time to the same bot. So that's pretty cool. You can debug, you know, side by side. I can split this over to the other tab, and I can, you know, have a little conversation over here and have a completely, you know, conversation or a completely independent conversation in the left window.
That's nice. So if you're lonely, you can open as many chats
right,
as you want.
You can feel like you're, you know, so popular.
Awesome. That's how I'm going to feel popular today, friends.
Okay, and then one final thing we'll show you guys is this new services tab we have over here.
Holy cow, that's amazing.
Yeah, so you can connect things like Lewis and Q&A Maker and even to the Azure Bot Service with these services. And basically what you do is you just open this, you type in the name of your Lewis app, the application ID, the authoring key, version, et cetera, and then you submit, and now your bot can key off of these new Lewis traces. So let's take a look at this. I already have Lewis hooked up to this. So if we say, you know, let's start over this conversation, and then I can just say, you know, hey, and if we look in this log over here to the right, we can see that, oh, we have this new thing called a Lewis trace. And so now we can click on this Lewis trace, and in this inspector, it has the model name of my Lewis model, it has the app ID, and it has all the results from Lewis saying, oh, here's what you scored, here's the top scoring intent. Okay, and so.
Well, that's super handy. I mean, like, because Usually it just goes and it comes back and you're like, what happened? And you got to look at the logs over there. But this is hooking directly up to the service and then getting all of the logs that are happening.
Right, so it's no longer a black box that you just kind of have to, you know, cross your fingers and hope everything works out.
Which I do with all my software.
Right, and so on the left here, what's really cool is that you can click this Lewis link and it will deep link right into the language model in the Lewis portal. So you can tweak your language models, you know, right here in the Lewis portal. But I know what you're saying. You're saying, oh, you know, Tony, I really don't want to leave your beautiful new app.
I didn't want to make it awkward.
Exactly.
For
we
both
just
of us.
Gave it a such a nice UI. Right. I don't want to leave. It's so awesome and sleek. And we're saying, okay, yeah, we kind of feel that way too. So what you can do now is let's say we're gonna start over in this conversation and we're gonna say something like, howdy, partner, to the bot. Oh, okay, it actually understood that. Howdy there. Okay, so it says, sorry, I do not understand that. So we're going to go and we're going to click on this Lewis trace. And we're going to see that it scored none as the highest intent. So what we're going to do is mark that as a greeting. Yeah, and so now you'll see train light up over here in the corner. We can now training. It was successful. We can now publish this model. And so it just went and published that. So now if we start over, we should be able to say, howdy there. And it says hello. So it knows it's a greeting now. So yeah, that's something we're really excited about. And that's our new plugin model. And a lot of developers are going to be able to create these custom traces that they'll be able to key off of and present their own UI in the inspector panel.
All right, Tony, thanks so much for spending some time with us. We've been learning all about the Bot Framework Emulator, which is pretty cool. You can do a ton of things in it. Thanks so much for watching. We'll see you next time. Take care.